a good day to feel beautiful.
It is.
Welcome to Makna Talks Beauty with me, Shahnaz.
And I'm Selemani. And a very, very special guest.
Ta-da!
Literally! Literally! Ta-da! What's up, Tara?
I'm good. It feels good untuk pertama kalinya ngobrol-ngobrol lagi bareng-bareng cewek-cewek rame-rame. Aww. Talking about silly things. Yeah. I'm excited.
We're gonna pop your cherry.
Oh!
Girl, let's get into that. Some juicy
gossip. We're going to talk about first love. Okay. Jeez. Tapi kita mulainya dari mana, Mat? Enak kan ngomongin what is love to you?
Oh, damn.
The definition of love.
Aku sakit kepala nih kalau ngomongin what is love. Yeah, what is love to you?
Apa, dari lagu deh apa gitu. It's my first love.
Aku enggak tahu itu lagu apa sih.
Oh my god.
Terlalu muda emang.
Aku tuh baru lahir 2005.
Okay.
Jadi aku enggak tahu.
Oh, ini lagi intern ya
pertama kali aku di sini. Aku enggak tahu. Terus siapa yang nyanyi?
Itu
Hailey Bieber.
Oh my god.
Bukan, Selena Gomez.
Oh, oh iya.
Enggak, sorry, sorry.
But yeah, love is what I think is sesuatu.
Sesuatu
filosofical tapi enggak bisa.
Apa?
But I think in a sense of first love, it's the one that you really really like.
Someone.
Like, that's the thing that you just like. That is it.
A thing or a person?
A thing.
A thing.
Okay. But like, a thing, a boo thing.
It's a boo thing. You know what I'm saying?
Okay. Kalau buat Tara?
Well, I think special someone yang bikin lo ngerasa there's a Godzilla in your stomach. In a way.
Godzilla.
Or for me, maybe my first love was my parents or my dad.
Right.
Oh, like yeah, I think so.
That's so wholesome. That's not like my answer at all. Yeah. I was just like, love is an obsession and a possession.
Toxic.
Obsession and possession. Okay.
Kalo
that's
apa?
Interesting. Kalau buat gua, love, nggak tahu ya. Kayak mungkin the first time that you feel vulnerable, gimana ya? Lo
tiga
di. Guys, ini baru menit pertama. Please tone it down.
Okay. Mungkin the first time gue ngerasa care about someone. Ooh. Mungkin ya. Iya nggak sih?
And who that be?
Ya mungkin bisa kayak mungkin bokap kali ya yang kayak gue ngerasa benar-benar. Karena kan sebelum tidur lo biasanya diceritain gitu ya. Diceritain kayak dongeng-dongeng gitu kan sama bokap gue. Gue jadi mungkin ngerasa kayak, ya mungkin itu kali ya pertama first love. Tapi kalau in terms of first banget orang lain tuh ya ada sih. Yang bukan, yang...
Should we go into
that? Should we unpack that?
Tapi kayaknya itu lebih menarik sih. Maksudnya...
Yeah. Gereget lah, kayak cinta kita banyak gitu.
Iya, kalau orang tua kan of course ya pasti gitu. Terus kayak pets, ya iya juga gitu. Pasti kan lo punya binatang peliharaan. Tapi kalau orang luar.
Pets dulu baru orang luar.
Baru orang. Karena iya, gue lebih peduli sama pets sih sebenarnya.
Karena di rumah kan.
Iya, yeah.
So it's like, oh my god, my family.
Iya. Berarti kalau dari orang luar tuh, kira-kira first love lo umur berapa?
First crush sama love beda gak?
Kayaknya beda ya. Crush tuh kayak lo naksir doang gak sih? Tapi first love kayak the first time you feel something.
Tapi menurut gue crush tuh bisa dihitung sebagai first love.
Oh ya?
Cause as a teenager, do you know what love is?
True!
I wanna know what
true.
Love is!
True! Iya bener.
Ya so, definisinya masih berantakan sih, tapi kan lo belajar.
Ooh, she got deep again. Like,
I'm sorry, I can't help it.
Like, we're trying to like ball and you're trying to like sprawl. No, oh, but like yeah, I think yeah, first crush termasuk sih.
Kalau lo crushnya mungkin sampai wah gitu kali ya, obses banget gitu mungkin.
Yeah, that's my definition. Yo, that's toxic ass.
First crush mungkin kelas 4 SD kali ya.
Oh.
Start so early.
Develop
okay,
early.
Is it a fictional character?
No, it's not. It could be.
Yeah,
dulu
kan?
Tuh sempet gue cinta banget sama Westlife.
Okay,
maybe you don't know.
Iya, ngerti.
Siapa lagi gue tuh?
You don't know?
Tahu siapa, yang mana. Westlife kan ada 4 toh.
Shame.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Girl, is he the gay one? I'm not sure.
Lo pura-pura gak tahu kan tadi?
Hah, aku tahu.
Oh, jadi lima, Shane.
Okay. Jadi dulu di kamar gue ada kayak zaman dulu tuh masih ada Photoshop katro gitu, poster of five of the members with me in the middle.
Di dulu masih ada.
Whatever. Tapi ini Photoshop ya, bukan foto beneran.
Oh, okay. Jadi lo kayak crop lewat kayak Microsoft Paint.
No, like I ordered. Terus itu gue gantung di kamar, katrok banget gak sih? Sampai sekarang gue masih dikata-katain sama kakak gue yang kayak, iya dulu sama Wesley. Terus gue malu banget.
Oh my god, I'm very happy to say that I've never done that.
Really? Tapi ya, generasi sekarang tuh gak ngerasain rasanya ngambil poster di tengah-tengah majalah.
Yeah,
and then you put it up on the wall. That's, it was a thing.
Yeah, that was like hard labor.
Yeah.
Kids these days could never.
Tinggal di scroll yeah, dong.
Bener sih.
Save di sini my life.
Heart labor.
Sumpah sebenernya kayak ditempel.
Iya sih.
Jinjit.
Ya udah, first love-nya apa?
Gua apa?
Oh, wow. Iya, inanimate object.
I loved my bed. Enggak sih. Cuman kalau gua, if we talk fictional characters, go Little Mermaid.
Oh, Ariel? I used
girl?
To be a Little Mermaid too. Oh,
see, that's why I asked you. Is it a fictional character?
Yeah.
The man was fictional to the max. Was it kayak the red hair?
Yeah.
The fin. Okay, I wanted to be a fish.
You wanted to be a fish? Flounder?
Yeah, I wanted to be flounder.
You wanted to be flounder?
Yeah. Flounder is a cutie though.
He is. Yeah. He's so cute. He's me. Oh my god. But anyways, yeah, Little Mermaid. Karena kayak, who didn't fall in love with this like gorgeous girl and kayak
of
di pantai.
Dia kayak little princess.
Cute clamshell bra that would never fit. Yeah. Whoa. Like I would need like a fucking crack in here, but
pinggangnya cuma segini.
Iya, pinggangnya cuma segini. It's kayak, what do you eat, girl?
Plankton?
She's like plankton. Seaweed. I guess that's why she's out all the time. Sorry.
Seaweed.
But yeah, Little Mermaid was my first love because she's very sweet and she sings.
Yeah.
Yes, oh my god, unpacking childhood shit.
Tapi dia kan
maybe lo jadi suka nyanyi gara-gara Little Mermaid.
Exclusive on Talks Beauty.
Yeah.
Yeah, that. Oh, founder.
Kalau gue boleh pikirkan fictional character sih, gue suka banget sama Lion King kan.
No. We're not gonna talk about fictional character. We obviously know it's not.
Giliran ke gue aja
nggak boleh. Fictional character.
Ya udah, karena gue punya banyak banget cinta di dalam.
Iya, love.
Pertama kali mungkin SMP ya. Kalau first crush mungkin.
Oh, sweat.
Kalau first crush kayaknya SD, tapi kayaknya cowoknya nggak suka balik, jadi whatever. Terus kalau first love, bisa gue bilang first love karena ya udah abis itu kita, oh iya kayaknya kita jadian nih.
Oh,
gitu.
Cinta monyet.
Oh, banget.
Terus, ini apa, umur berapa?
Kayak 13 atau 14 tahun ya?
Okay.
13 atau 14 tahun. Terus kayak iya, we went on a date. Terus kayak nonton bioskop.
Wow. Okay. First date-nya bioskop.
Kayak kalau enggak salah ya, gue juga lupa. Okay. Lupa banget sumpah. Cuma ya ada orangnya kakak kelas di SMP itu. Terus ya gitu tiap lihat kayak meskipun sekarang ya iya kan, tapi lo punya kan pasti kan first love yang benar-benar tiap lo ketemu.
Sumpah ya, kalau di sekolah tuh gemes banget sih. I think one of the thing that I miss most being at school is just, you know, stalking your crush at school.
Berarti kayak, iya kita lagi ada kelas meeting, sekarang futsal lagi main.
Paling depan.
Apa? Futsal ya?
Apa basket? Kasti.
Oh my god, Kasti.
Oh my god, iya sih,
basket
Kasti. Kasti. Bola bakar. Iya, bola bakar.
Ya,
oh, bola kan enggak beda generasi sih.
Yang digebok gitu.
Iya, digebok.
Digebok.
Iya, to be honest, iya sih.
Iya kan?
Iya, bola bakar Kasti gitu. Tapi iya sih, oh my god. So seru banget.
Tapi ada tuh beberapa my school crush yang sekarang udah gede, pas gue liat tuh
kok gini ya? Iya, bener. Oh my god, iya.
Iya enggak sih kayak, Oh, wow.
Kayaknya dulu bagus
gitu. Ya, ya, what happened? Dulu kayaknya wah, ngeliat tuh kayak ada hati-hati di mata gitu.
Cinta itu buta.
Iya benar. Yes,
apalagi kalau kau anak kecil.
Oh my god. Aduh.
Tahu apa kamu?
What was the most embarrassing that you've ever done?
To like in front of my crush?
Yeah, in front of your god. Crush or something to your crush.
Jadi gini ceritanya. Dulu pas SMP, my first crush itu sama kayak Ines, well, not same person, but situasinya sama. Dia kelas gue 2 tahun di atas.
Lo kelas 1, dia kelas 3 kan?
Iya, yeah, gue kelas 1, kelas 3.
Kayak selalu kayak gitu deh.
Dia tuh drummer.
Oh my god.
Abis itu penabuh dia hati. Dia tuh kayak menabuh gendang kalau misalnya lagi nari saman.
Gitu ya.
Asli dia tuh kalau misalnya lagi ada, lu kan gue di sekolah Islam kan.
Iya.
Kalau misalnya sholat zuhur tuh kayak ramai-ramai gitu loh di kayak hall
wow.
gede. Terus dia ya. Tuh paling mana sih sampai di Pondok Aren.
Oke, Pondok Aren.
Ya, Sun Bintaro.
Okay.
Bintaro area.
Oke.
Di situ terus dia selalu yang kayak azan iqomat itu loh, gue kayak oh my god, like his voice is like, it's calling my name, it's like the voice of the heavens, like oh my god, like alhamdulillah, yes, be my imam gitu. Kayak the vibes is like, you know, like imami aku gitu loh. Cuman jadi kayak gue
when
kayak,
you were 13,
when I was 13, okay. I had my first love, then somebody like to pay, then
gitu.
Terus akhirnya kayak we ended up, I got a phone.
Okay. Huh? Soalnya apa sih zaman dulu nih?
Gua Nokia.
Yang?
Nokia yang 3220 yang ada bumper-bumpernya gitu.
Iya, 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 iya.
But anyway, she was popping like that. Yeah. Jadi gue suka nge-SMS dia. Oh my god.
This is oh my so embarrassing god.
Right now. Kalau nge-SMS gue yang kayak
untuk yang pernah SMS sama Gemet dulu pas SMP.
Do not text me now. Do not
we're talking about you right now.
Jadi gue SMS kan biasanya kayak halo, lagi apa? Enggak, assalamualaikum.
Oh my god, Nadia. Astagfirullah, Nadia.
Assalamualaikum, Kak. Siapa gitu.
Waalaikumsalam, Nat. Ada yang bisa dibantu.
Dia jawabnya gitu.
Oh my god, I'm triggered.
Nah,
iya. Iya, tapi dia cuma waalaikumsalam, Nat. Baik kok. Kamu lagi ngapain? Udah sholat belum?
And ya, look what I've become now.
Sorry. I mean not much different. Anyway. I'm still that little girl. That
ya ampun. Tapi waktu itu lo sholat beneran. Zuhur
for him.
Buat dia.
Oh, not that's for so God. Bad.
Yeah, for him.
That's so bad. Iya, aku udah sholat.
Jadi itu depan dia gitu sengaja ya, sholat.
Kayak, kalau misalnya udah tuh kayak pas buka kayak.
Gila sih, udah kayak iklan beauty gitu. Oh my lord. Iya gitu, that's the most embarrassing thing for me right now.
Yeah. Okay. What about you?
Most embarrassing thing.
Ya ampun, aku malu. Gila, gua gak pernah ngomongin dia selama-lamanya kayaknya sebelum ini.
Oh my god.
Karena Leo kan kayak gitu ya, jadi kalau kita once kita...
You're a Leo?
I'm a Leo.
What about you?
Girl guess.
Scorpio.
I wish. Oh. Enggak sih, I don't wish because I have the best zodiac in the world.
Which?
Aries.
Of course.
Hello? What about
girl,
you?
Girl, Gemini sih?
Gemini.
Oh.
Girl,
oh.
How do you know?
Okay.
Oh.
I've been sucking you.
Okay. Okay, what was the most embarrassing thing?
Kalau gue dulu, gue tuh sama sampai sekarang gue pendapat gue adalah kalau lo suka duluan tuh nggak apa-apa menurut gue ya. Jadi buat perempuan tuh kadang-kadang suka gue nggak mau make the first move gitu, tapi it's okay kalau lo emang beneran suka, nggak usah ditebak-tebak gitu loh. Maksud gue, nah back then
I'm like replaying all of my ini juga.
Back then kayaknya gue tuh nanya itu siapa sih kak gitu kan, terus disambut. Tapi itu tuh gue nanyanya tuh ke kakak kelas gue yang satu lagi yang cewek.
Yeah.
Lewat surat menyurat gitu,
Bro. Oh my god, so cute.
So cute ya. Aduh. Terus gue nanya, "Itu Kak yang pakai sepatu ini tuh siapa?" gitu.
Sepatu.
Oh my god. Gue tuh sukanya sama sepatu putih sampai sekarang ya. Jadi gue lihat dia main bola pakai sepatu putih gitu.
Terus
gue suka.
That's to my heart. Wow. A goal to my heart. Score in my heart. Gitu
kayak. Nah, ya udah, mulai dari situ terus kayak si kakak kelas yang cewek ini ngasih tahu ke dia gitu, eh lo ditanyain nih sama di kelas ini si ini gitu kan. Terus gue dipanggil kayak ke tempat tongkrongan.
Takut deh gue.
Serem kan, terus kan lo gak mungkin nolak kan, gak mungkin kayak, kak I'm too busy, sorry gitu kan. Gak mungkin kan, yaudah gue datang. Terus kayak, kak kenapa ya kak aku dipanggil? Lo catat ya nomor teleponnya dia, nanti malam telepon gitu.
Ini yang ngomong cewek apa cowok?
Siang cewek.
Oh, kok dia terus BA?
Makanya, mungkin dia biro jodoh, gue gak ngerti. Terus di cowok ini kayak, tujuh tiga berapa gitu, terus gak, ya kak.
Oh my god, you call them first.
Iya, yeah, okay. Karena disuruh kan, takut. Ya udah terus.
Halo kak.
Halo kak. Oh my
god. Gue gak bisa ngomongin gini-gini. Udah so, ini aja episode ini aja ngomongin
gini. Gue udah cerita ya. Why am I here by the way?
During this episode.
Cerita juga.
Udah sekarang lo gimana? Abis ini udah
ya. My most embarrassing. Well, oh my god,
banyak
used to be aggressive psycho, but well, gue inget banget. Girl. One of my memory was I had this huge crush on this boy di sekolah. Terus lagi istirahat, gue ngikutin dia dong. Hai, gitu-gitu. Terus udah gitu.
Ini SMP. SD.
Oh my god, SD.
Terus dia lagi senderan di tembok gitu, lagi ngobrol-ngobrol. Terus gue deketin, gue gituin.
Holy,
you were 9.
I was 9.
Where did you learn that?
Judge me. Terus cowoknya gimana?
Cowoknya kayak kabur cuy. Setelah itu.
Tapi lo masih ngejar nggak?
Iya, setelah itu gue tetap aja yang kayak gitu-gitu.
Oh, okay. Terus dalih lo apa? Dalih lo apa?
Gak apa-apa, naksir aja.
Oh, gitu. Lo berarti ngaku aja naksir.
Iya, gitu. Iya. Gue bilang kayak, oh my god, I'm huge crush on you, gue suka banget.
Terus dia bilang apa?
Ya udah, I was rejected, obviously.
What did he say? He didn't say anything, he ran off.
So since then, dia ngeliat gue tuh yang kayak...
Good riddance.
Cool.
Kasih ya. He doesn't deserve it. He doesn't deserve it.
Ooh, he touched again.
Oh my god. Ooh. A moment.
A moment.
Oh ya ya, itu tapi harus dilewatin nggak sih? Semua orang kan punya first crush dan berkembang jadi first love nggak menurut lo?
Gue ya,
I think.
Yeah.
Of course.
Masa sih, masa kayak
itu bumbu-bumbu kehidupan.
Gini-gini, what the did you learn?
Iya. Yeah.
Dari first love lo apa yang lo pelajari?
Oh. Oh my god.
I learned that all my old crushes had crushes on my best friend.
Oh. Kok bisa sih? Kok bisa sih? Masalah.
This is why I don't like talking about this. Kasian.
Like literally, I tried to be like her. Jadi dulu tuh kayak sahabatku banget gitu. Gue tuh I was trying to be her twin lah intinya karena I feel like she's such a great person. Dia pinter, dia alim, whatever lah. Like, kayak she has a great persona gitu-gitu. Jadi gue tuh nyoba menjadi dia gitu. Tapi jatuhnya, I don't know why, maybe I'm cursed. Tapi kayak setiap kali gue suka sama orang, gue curhat ke dia dong. Iya nih dia lucu ya, gini kita bikin code words. Kayak misalnya, nama dia aslinya Dimas, kita manggilnya kayak Daun gitu atau apa ya. Oh, anak SMP lo mikir apa sih gitu.
Iya,
terus ya, namanya Daun gitu. Terus kayak, iya Daun gini-gini lali-lali. Terus Daun ulang tahun, gue beliin tas. Tas skater gitu kak, cause he skates or whatever.
Oh terus, my god,
it is a different crush by the way, bukan kak,
okay, bukan yang itu
yang tadi.
Okay.
Gue pikir dia keren banget Imam yang bisa
one skate. One out of 5,000 crushes, right?
I mean two, thousand, not 5,000.
Okay. Terus.
Not that much, just 2,000. Abis itu kalau gue cerita ke dia, ke sahabat gue kayak, oh gitu, oh, lucu, okay, cool. Abis itu kayak in the next couple of days, nanti kayak cowok ini kayak ngobrol gue, eh by the way itu temen lo apa kabar? Gue boleh minta nomornya nggak?
Iyo.
Gue kayak,
oke. Okay, yang kita butuh tahu adalah respon sahabat lo apa?
Gue, oh my god, I used to self sabotage myself a lot. Jadi kayak, oh, gue suka sama dia tapi dia suka sama sahabat gue. Jadi gue kayak, I guess kalau misalnya dia mau suka sama temen gue, I guess he would be happier, my best friend.
Oh my.
Jadi lo terus kayak, jadi gue kayak ngasih nomor sahabat gue.
Terus sahabat lo gimana?
Terus sahabat gue ya nanggepin aja. Tapi nggak cerita sama gue.
What?
Tiba-tiba tahu-taunya kayak cowok ini kayak
she don't deserve you and
Jadi ya, sekarang dia bukan sahabat lo lagi kan?
No, ya, kita udah gak ketemu dari ya.
Ya itu SMP. Baru good riddance.
Iya, kayak thank you.
Oh my god.
Thank you so much. Okay, that's me. Okay. Back to you.
Back what
to
about you? Me?
What did you learn?
What did you learn about your crush?
I learned about love. My crush. Don't be a psychotic aggressive bitch. Don't.
And then did you learn from that? Did you turn into a not psycho bitch?
I didn't. For a while, a bit.
Oh, yo, for no. A while a bit?
For a while a
how
bit.
Could you, how could you hide that? I could hide mine. Like, I'm a psycho bitch.
Extrovert mungkin gue, jadi kayak...
Keluar kemana-mana.
Iya, iya sih. Kalau lo pelajaran yang lo pelajari, pelajaran yang lo pelajari
pelajaran
di sekolah,
pelajari. Anjrit, kenapa gue gak pernah punya jawaban?
Tapi lo nanya terus.
Because I'm an interviewer.
Okay,
please.
Girl. Damn, she's a professional.
Dia masih on ini ya, on cue card.
Yeah. Nggak, gue gak pelajarin apa-apa, gue pelajarin.
Okay, wait, gini.
Just stay strong.
Dan, stay strong. Jadi dan setiap malu dia kayak
lewatin ini.
Iya. Just another day.
Iya, Bo, karena menurut gue ya udah lo. Akhirnya lo harus ngelewatin aja gitu, yeah, karena itu fase aja gitu. Dia, lo suka sama dia suka, terus kemudian pacaran. Terus abis itu kayak, bang kayak dia sukanya sama kakak kelas gue abis itu. Terus harus, terus kayak,
all the
came,
pain.
Came the first heartbroken gue yang gue nangis-nangis dulu gitu. Tapi ya udah, abis itu yang gue pelajarin adalah sebenarnya kalau lo belajar, maksudnya pacaran itu adalah part of learning juga gitu, ya gak sih? Karena di umur-umur segitu kayak dunianya kan masih kecil tuh. Terus gue gak pernah mencoba untuk ngobrol sama banyak, saat itu ya gak, ya cuma teman-teman itu aja kan. Cuma ketika lo punya pacar tuh kayak, aku tuh gak boleh marah terus ya gitu. Aku tuh gak, gue tuh punya masalah sama emosi ya, ya bener.
We're unpacking a lot of stuff.
Wow,
today.
Look at us, yes. A psycho-aggressive.
Let's go ahead.
A repressor. And a crazy maniac.
Dengan gue belajar, lo gak boleh marah-marah sama orang tuh. Yeah. Kalau lagi pacaran apalagi.
Oh my god, this is so interesting. Kayak tadi apalagi dia ngomongin soal her first heartbreak. Mm-hmm. Menurut lo, is there a happy ending in love?
You make the happy ending, bitch.
No,
like,
exactly.
You don't wait for it, you make it.
Exactly. These days, that's the mentality that everyone should have. Mm-hmm. Karena banyak banget, even me, for a long time, I thought happiness comes from my partner. Gitu. Yeah. Jadi gue selalu ekspektasi gue to find happiness, to find stability, to find safety from this other person. Mm-hmm. Dan ketika dia gak bisa provide itu, I will be terribly disappointed and blame that person yang seharusnya kan sebenarnya bukan tanggung jawab dia juga gitu. So, do you think there's a
happy ending?
Yeah, you fake it till you make it. Yeah, nggak you fake it sih. Maksudnya kayak you work towards make it. Karena I think this goes back into like how do you see yourself in this life? Kayak kalau misalnya lo mau dicintai,
dicintai,
kamu juga harus bisa mencintai. It's a two-way street.
It's not
a one-way. Or another.
I'm gonna get you. Yeah, yeah. Like, but regrets ya dulu nontonnya.
Iya.
Ya udah.
Ya udah.
Ya kan?
Ines Job.
Oh my god. Kembali ke topik.
Gue suka deh ada segmen baru Ines Jokes,
that's so cute.
Iya, kita dikit dulu apa gitu.
Karena juga gue bahas sih.
But yeah, kembali lagi tadi you were saying you used to suppress all of your emotions, kayak you had problems kayak menurut lo ya,
menurut gue.
Padahal mungkin sebenarnya itu manusiawi gitu.
Yeah.
So what kind of emotions that you had to suppress?
Iya, kayak kenapa harus kayak aku boleh marah?
Karena gue lioness. Semua orang gue semprot. Nggak, jadi ya kayak menurut gue first love itu ya udah lo belajar untuk mengelola emosi lo juga. Ya nggak sih, kayak lo lagi cinta-cintanya nih, gue lagi lagi sayang-sayangnya sih. Pada saat itu kayak sayangnya, ya sebenarnya sayang aja sih gitu, gak sayang banget. Cuma
ditaker.
Cuma kan abis itu gue harus, anjing nih cowok suka sama kelas gue gitu, deket sama dia lulus dari SMP itu, kemudian dia masuk SMA, terus dia kayak lebih seru sama teman-teman SMA-nya. Terus gue masih SMP kan, terus ya udah gue ditinggalin. Terus kayak gue gak bisa marah-marah karena kakak kelas yang dia naksir adalah nantinya kakak kelas gue.
Kasian.
Jadi my god, gue waktu masuk SMA, lo tuh yang mantannya gitu. Jadi gue
kayak sih sekolah kayak gitu sih.
Iya kan, emang salah aku gitu. Jadi ya.
But then again, so I wanted to ask, jadi sekarang menurut lo, how you perceive love, how you live love, gimana evolusinya dari from your first love up until now?
Wow, you're a professional interviewer.
Oh wow, terbalik ya. Karena daripada gue ditanya, gue tanya duluan gitu.
Kayak oh my god, self defense mechanism. Yeah, yeah. Let me ask the question. You answer.
Yeah. So
kalau gue lebih ke, well, love is not about possession. It's all about like being. It's so cliche. But it's about being brave, karena kayak you don't know when you're gonna get hurt.
That's true. Iya sih. Tapi gue disagree sih kalau lo bilang love is not possession.
Menurut lo ya?
Iyalah,
karena menurut gue kan disemprot gue takut nyet kayak. Ayo, cuman gue Aries tapi kenapa gue takut?
Can I have an opinion?
Menurut gue kayak rather than possession, lebih ke devotion. And I think it's different, right?
Iya, kalau devotion tuh secara sukarela you're devoted to that person instead of you be devoted to me, you're mine.
Cuma kalau lo gak punya dia sama sekali juga. Iya. Kalau lo nggak, kalau nggak ada legitimasi dari dia, kalau lo dalam relationship, ngapain lo cinta?
Iya, iya, iya.
Tepuk sebelah tangan ya nggak sih?
Iya, 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 iya.
Iya, that's true as well.
Kamu sih? Dia kayak, yeah, okay, fine.
People should worship me. Yeah, but then I think tadi kayak Tara bilang sesuatu yang lumayan interesting, kayak menurut lo dari kayak semua first love and first crush ini, kayak akhirnya. Do you believe in like a happy ending dari kayak semua? Yeah.
Do ya?
I think eventually there will be no happy ending karena lo yang create your own reality in a way, dan seperti yang gue ngomongin sebelumnya, pada akhirnya you learn that partner lo bukan seharusnya yang menjadi provider
of
your own happiness dan segala macam, dan itu buat gue. It was a rough journey buat gue akhirnya bisa, ternyata itu dari gue sendiri ya. Dan ada banyak banget momen-momen ketidaksiapan yang kayak, oh my god, I'm on my own now and everything is up to me. Karena gue kebiasaan dengan, oh I can't be alone, I have to be with someone all the time and gitu-gitu loh. So, I think moment of realization-nya tuh lumayan mencengangkan buat gue, dan gue sempet nervous sendiri yang kayak I don't think I can do this.
Itu kapan?
That was like 5 years ago probably.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, gue juga kayak, menurut gue kayak when you realize things about kayak, oh lo sebenarnya bertanggung jawab atas whatever ending that you want. Dan itu gue juga mungkin baru
your life probably.
Itu juga 5 tahun lalu gue kayak shit, yeah, I'm in this alone, dude. Like, I might want people in my life, but that's my, ya itu andil gue.
Iya.
Yang gak ada yang lagi yang bisa.
Even bahkan itu. Up to orang-orang yang lo allow into your life, itu juga up to you. How you're being treated by other people juga itu terserah lo kan. Which is menurut gue itu part of self love juga gitu, where you can set up boundaries for yourself.
Yeah, exactly.
Penting banget.
Iya sih.
Yeah, what do you think?
Ayo kenapa? Oh, no, differently. Karena kayak Ines tuh, she's been with her husband kayak half her life.
14 years.
Iya. Yeah. So I feel
how many years?
14.
14.
Yeah.
Almost 15 years.
Oh, this is interesting.
No, 15 years.
Yeah. How do you feel?
Nah itu. It's a bit different ya kalau menurut gue, karena ya itu gue pernah bilang gue grow up dengan orang ini gitu. Yeah, jadi my identity itu memang Ines dan Aldi, bukan Ines sendiri gitu. Right. Karena beda gitu zaman, maksudnya gue sendiri, gue selalu sendiri, gue selalu di dalam pikiran gue sendiri, tapi life decision gue dari dulu tuh Ines dan Aldi. Yeah. Jadi gue tuh selalu berdua gitu. Hmm. Jadi kalau lo tanya happiness, of course, karena kita dua-duanya datang dari mungkin bisa dibilang dark souls yang merasa tidak ada happiness di dalam dunia ini. Mm-hmm. But then kita ketemu happiness tuh di each other gitu ketika
that's
berdua.
So sweet.
Kayak it's fun ya gitu untuk berdua sama orang ini gitu. Dan kalau lo tanya lama ya lo bersama orang ini 15 tahun gitu, 8 tahun aja pacaran tuh nggak kerasa, karena menurut gue setiap hari tuh ada different layer yang gue temuin.
Yeah.
Dan karena kita tidak pernah expect apapun, kita gak pernah expect untuk happy, kita gak pernah expect untuk jatuh cinta, kita gak pernah expect untuk selama ini bersama dengan orang ini gitu loh. Jadi karena gak ada ekspektasi, jadi jatuhnya jalanin aja.
I think that's so important, karena one thing that I learned from my partner, that expectation kills everything.
Yes.
So I think it's important to have no expectation when you walk in this journey called life.
Right. Tapi menurut gue ekspektasi itu, I think for di generalnya you should talk it out.
Yeah.
Harus itu sesuatu bukan yang lo set tapi lo discuss gitu. Jadi kayak bisa jalannya bareng-bareng. Yeah. Kalau enggak ketemu bisa discuss, karena of course two brains is better than one.
Yeah.
Kalau ada masalah jadi disolve bareng-bareng, which is great. Oh. I mean, I'm not married or whatever, but yeah, I understand. Like some people call me mature. But maybe that's just my mind talking to me. But yeah, I totally agree. Kalau misalnya expectation lo jadinya lega gitu.
Yeah.
But and I think it's important to also be like that to yourself as well. Yeah. Karena kadang-kadang kalau ekspektasi ke diri lo sendiri tuh lo malah lebih harsh menurut gue.
Yeah. No, a lot of people are being very very harsh towards themselves tanpa disadari ya. Tapi kalau misalkan dipilah-pilah lagi, kita if we can watch ourselves in a CCTV every day, we would be like what the fuck? Like iya kan?
Iya. Yeah. Tapi ya intinya adalah menjalani, Bo. Kembali lagi.
Iya, jalanin aja.
Gua kayak hardcore realistic banget.
Iya, iya, iya. No, kita berdua mungkin kayak
dreamy. Iya. Iya, kita agak-agak twinkle little star sih, to be honest, ya. Kita kayak what you are.
Iya, iya.
Oke. Tapi kembali lagi, enjoy the journey.
Iya, enjoy the journey. And I feel like kalau misalnya lo enggak tahu diri lo sendiri, kayak for example tadi first crush lo, kayak I feel like as a 9 year old or 10, you were like in 4th grade. Lo udah yakin gitu dengan diri lo, kayak ya udah ini cara gue kayak gini, I like you, that's how I tell you about it. If you can't handle it, you can't handle me.
Iya, benar.
Right? Kayak makanya dia mencit. Terus ya udah, dan I think dari situ kayak
yang berarti enggak cocok.
Kalau itu enggak cocok dan lo sadar, okay, itu good riddance and I will look for the tribe that evolves.
Somehow susah banget sih untuk to express yourself in terms of self love ya, kayak banyak banget yang akhirnya bisa kehilangan teman, kehilangan even sometimes family, you know, best friends, tapi pada ujungnya bikin sadar kalau ujung-ujungnya the people yang end up in your own circle tuh benar-benar helps you apa ya, blossom in a way.
Yeah. Oh, I love that word.
Blossom.
Commander and the leader. Blossom. Powerpuff Girls.
Okay.
Yeah.
Gue jadi bingung.
Kok jadi bingung?
Indeed.
Indeed. Suddenly she, you're so assertive right now, madam.
Ya ampun. Ya. Oke. Jadi semoga semua juga bisa menemukan cintanya masing-masing. Happiness in you.
In yourself.
You create your own happiness.
Yes.
Don't let anybody make your own fucking happiness. Listen to your own and not Oh my god.
Oh my god, my salad. Yes. Nanti kita akan cerita tentang lebih banyak lagi tentang salad.
Kita bakal cerita lebih banyak tentang salad, but yeah, thank you so much Tara for being
thank
here.
Thank you, my
thank you,
Tara. Thank you, live studio audience.
Di sini ada 1500 penonton. Terima kasih banyak. Thank you for tuning in and thank you for watching this episode. Dan kita akan kembali lagi next week dengan episode lainnya. Thank
dengan
you.
Topik yang juicy. Juicy topic, so we'll see you next week.
Bye guys.
Bye.